Today, we're looking at this 2011 Toyota Prius. We're going to emphasize the cooling fan motor for the hybrid voltage battery. This high voltage battery requires a significant amount of cooling to maintain the batteries at the right temperature. That temperature is being continuously monitored by the onboard computer. This vehicle has already been safed. And what I mean by that the high voltage system has been disabled on this vehicle and it's completely isolated to the high voltage battery. That's why you see our protective gear here and the service plug has been removed. What I'm gonna do now is show you where this blower motor is at and then show you the operation of it. I'll take this vent off and then we're gonna put this vent back up. I just wanna give you a good visual of where this blower motor is. So this blower motor to cool off this high voltage battery gets its fresh air from the ductwork here. You can see the ductwork where it's pulling air from the cabin into the blower motor. Then it is pushed underneath the high voltage battery. It comes up through passageways in the high voltage battery. And this is where it exits out to atmosphere. We have the plumbing taken out of here and the vents taken off of here. So you can't see the rest of it where it takes that out to atmosphere. What we're gonna do now is go over to the bench or the table and take a little bit better look at what this cooling fan blower motor looks like. Now that we've taken a look at how this cooling fan motor works on the vehicle, let's give you a better understanding of how it works by looking at it here on the table. This is where the fresh air comes in from the cabin. The fresh air now is pushed out the bottom of this blower motor, and it is sent to the battery module underneath all the battery pack modules that are inside there. It comes up through the battery modules and exits out the top. That black vent that we took off shows you where the air is coming out of that high voltage battery module. So not only do you have the blower motor itself, you also have the harness on this side that provides the control and the feedback. Inside this blower motor, you have a very basic squirrel cage assembly that rotates like your conventional blower motor. I'm gonna spin this around one more time. Just like we're used to on blower motors, we have control and feedback that the module is looking at. This is a very important piece to maintain that high voltage battery at the proper temperature. A little best practice or tech tip that I want to pass along on these is that if you have a high voltage battery that has failed, it is a good idea to change the cooling fan motor when you're putting in that battery module or that battery pack into that vehicle. One thing that can cause repeat failures of the high voltage battery is not enough air circulation. We don't want to take a chance, so it's a good practice to change this if you're replacing the high voltage battery on this vehicle. Hopefully this gives you a better understanding of how these cooling fan motors work and have a better understanding the importance of the proper operation of them and making sure that when you're changing the high voltage battery, that it is working properly or being replaced. Thank you.